the Department of Transportation, or DOTr, wants to ease physical distancing in all forms of public transportation by Monday, September 14. In a statement released Friday, September 11, Transportation Secretary Arthur Tugade announces physical distancing will be decreased from 1 meter to 0.75 meters. This will increase the passenger load of all modes of public transportation. Tugade says the DOTr and the Economic Development Cluster got the approval and support of the National Task Force Against COVID-19 and the Interagency Task Force. For modern public utility vehicles and buses, the DOTr says the new policy would allow standing passengers. But in a briefing later that day, Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergara clarifies the safety aspect of the new DOTr policy is still being discussed. The DOTr later says implementation will be announced once they are made aware of what will be decided by the DOH, the Economic Development Cluster, DOTr, and the IATF. The country's economic managers have been pushing for public transportation to be further reopened to help jumpstart the economy. Meanwhile, the DOH says the World Health Organization's solidarity trials for a potential COVID-19 vaccine may start by the end of October. Vergara says the WHO, along with Filipino state scientists, are reviewing a list of 34 vaccines for trials. As of Friday, COVID-19 cases in the Philippines breached 250,000 as the DOH reports 4,040 new cases. Justice Secretary Menardo Guevarra says it's time for Filipinos to move on from the case of U.S. Marine Joseph Scott Pemberton. Guevarra on Friday, September 11, says President Rodrigo Duterte has already explained why he granted the soldier absolute pardon, making it the end of the story. Guevarra says, quote, "My sentiments are irrelevant. I defer to the personal judgments of the president on matters within his constitutional prerogative." Pemberton is in the process of being released from his special detention facility at the Philippine military headquarters, Camp Aguinaldo, and deported to the U.S. Friday afternoon. Pemberton was convicted of homicide for killing transgender woman Jennifer Laude. He had only served 6 of his 10-year sentence when Duterte granted him absolute pardon. The Department of Justice and the Office of the Solicitor General earlier opposed Pemberton's early release under the good conduct time allowance, but their work was overruled by Duterte's snap decision. Filipinos online make hashtag Araw na Magnanahaw trend on Twitter Friday, September 11, the birthday of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos. Hashtag Araw na Magnanahaw lands the top trending spot on Twitter Philippines. Like a yearly tradition, infographics flooded Twitter timelines to remind citizens of atrocities during the Marcos regime. Several tweets also cite Marcos as the Guinness Book's world record holder for greatest robbery of a government. Twitter user @KevinCalbo meanwhile draws a gender reveal comic of a baby dictator. This comes after the House of Representatives swiftly approved on final reading House Bill No. 7137 on Wednesday, September 2, declaring September 11 President Ferdinand Edralin Marcos Day in Ilocos Norte. The move was widely criticized by lawmakers and youth groups, calling it a colossal desecration of our history. United States President Donald Trump denies lying to Americans about the severity of the coronavirus after a bombshell new book by journalist Bob Woodward reveals he deliberately downplayed the crisis. Trump's taped admission to Woodward that he minimized the pandemic in public, while being aware from the start about the unique danger presented by COVID-19, set off alarm bells less than 8 weeks before Election Day. Trump insists he softened the dangers in public so that people won't panic. He says, quote, "I don't want to jump up and down and start screaming death, death." He also hits Woodward, calling him this whack job that wrote the book. This comes as Trump struggles in the polls leading up to elections in November against Democrat Joe Biden. Trump faces overwhelming disapproval from Americans on the handling of the coronavirus crisis. A post claiming polymerase chain reaction or PCR tests are unable to distinguish COVID-19 from other illnesses is false. The post claims PCR, or more commonly known as swab test, can't tell COVID-19 apart from measles, Ebola, or the common cold. The photo attached to the claim cites a line from a fact sheet for clinicians released by the Australian Department of Health, which reads, "It should be noted that PCR tests cannot distinguish between live virus and non-infective ribonucleic acid." The line on PCR tests being unable to distinguish between live and non-infective RNA is taken out of context. It was lifted from the section of the fact sheet labeled, "Can reinfection occur?" A spokesperson from the Australian Department of Health says the test for SARS-CoV-2 will not detect other pathogens. Filipino molecular biology professor Pia Bagamas-Budd explains COVID-19 real-time PCR tests only detect the sequences unique to the SARS-CoV-2 virus, which cannot be found in other RNA viruses. RT-PCR tests are considered the gold standard for COVID-19 testing.